In this video, you'll see how you can meet your operational goals with AWS Managed Services Accelerate. With this operations plan, you can achieve resilient and optimized AWS workloads through 24/7 activity monitoring and incident management based on National Institute of Standards and Technology, or NIST, best practices. On the documentation page, you'll find the AMS Accelerate User Guide, which provides a detailed service description. Here, you can learn more about AWS Managed Services Accelerate features, which include incident management, monitoring, security management, patch management, backup management, designated experts, operations tools, and logging and reporting. The service description also covers supported configurations and services, and roles and responsibilities. Before we begin our demonstration, let's quickly view the AWS Managed Services console and resources managed by AMS. This AWS account has already been onboarded to AMS Accelerate. Let's open the Managed Services console. The dashboard provides an overview of the current status of this account, including incidents on resources, compliance status, and account-level security. We can also open an incident or service request from here. The Reports page contains default reports provided by the AMS Self-Service Reporting, or SSR, feature. We can request certain additional reports and generate some reports on our own. And on this page, we can customize common configuration actions to ensure resources are being managed successfully and according to our specifications. Next, let's go to CloudWatch to see the resources being monitored by AMS. We can use these custom dashboards to explore how many resources are being monitored by AMS and how many are not. Let's select the AMS Resource Tagger Reporting dashboard for the US East 1 region. In this account, AMS is monitoring Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or Amazon EC2 instances, a NAT gateway, a load balancer, and an RDS database. Now, to begin our demonstration, let's go to the Amazon EC2 console and launch a new instance. AMS monitors more services than just Amazon EC2 and more types of failures, but in this example, we'll show EC2 in an unhealthy state due to high CPU usage. For demonstration purposes, we'll launch the instance directly from the console rather than creating it from code, and then skip ahead in time to when the instance has been configured and deployed. Here you can see that the EC2 instance we created is running. It has 6 alarms, some of which are still being activated. Next, we'll force the instance into an unhealthy status by disabling the interface, thereby activating the automated monitoring provided by AMS Accelerate. Once the instance is unhealthy, AMS will notify our group of expert engineers and run some automated remediation. For a quick way to do this, let's connect to the instance using AWS Systems Manager Session Manager. Let's capture the configuration. Then we'll bring down the interface. Let's check back on our EC2 instance. We'll do a refresh. As you can see, only one of 2 status checks passed, and an alarm has been raised since we disabled the interface. Let's view the status check failed alarm. We can refresh the graph and other alarms. The CloudWatch alarm has captured the time the alarm was activated and other details. AMS Accelerate automatically creates an AWS support case in the event of a raised alarm. Let's visit the AWS Support Center to find the open support case. Here's the case. Let's view it. We can see details on the case's creation and status, as well as correspondence from the AWS Managed Services team assigned to resolve the issue. For this case, an automated healing system will attempt to recover the instance. If the automated healing system fails to resolve the issue, an AWS operational engineer will review the issue and take the necessary actions. A few minutes later, we can see that the instance has returned to a healthy status. Let's connect to the instance again. The interface connection is active and working well. Let's return to the EC2 console. One alarm is still active. Although AMS Accelerate resolved the problem and the instance is in a healthy state, the alarm can take a few minutes to reset. The alarm has cleared. We can drill into the alarm to see its history. On the graph and in the timeline, we can see when the check failed, the duration of the failure, and when it was resolved. Let's visit the AWS Support Center to view the resolution of the AMS Accelerate support case that was generated by this alarm. Here's the correspondence we saw earlier, noting that an issue was detected with the EC2 instance, rendering it inaccessible. The follow-up message explains the outcome of efforts to troubleshoot the case. The AMS Accelerate incident management process quickly restored the instance to normal operation and provided updates along the way. You've just seen how you can meet your operational goals with AWS Managed Services Accelerate. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.